Okay, so my new solar panels came in today, just a couple hours ago. So I made a video of me unboxing them and everything just to make sure that they weren't broken or anything like that. And it's really long. So to keep the video short, I'm just going to show you these panels here real quick. They are 17.2 volts, 50 watts each, and we'll connect them together to give us 100 watts total. And then they each came with a charge controller, which I'll show you in a minute, and these UVA, UVB keychain things, which are a little cheesy, but I'll show you those as well. And basically, we chose these panels because they are designed to work in even the lowest of light situations. So even on very cloudy days, these will still gather energy. And they gather energy from multiple sources of light, UVA, UVB, white light. You can shine a flashlight on this and it'll collect the photons. So obviously, the more light you have, and the better the light source, the better the power output. But when you're living off of solar, even the slightest little bit of light is better than no light. So these panels, compared to other panels that we were checking out, there were bigger panels and for a better price range, but you had to order them in bulk. And some of the panels that we did want to get, the shipping cost just as much as the panel did, and it was going to be like $500 to get two panels, and it was $250 for the two panels plus $250 for shipping, and you can only buy two panels at a time. And so we went ahead and went with these because the shipping cost and the panel cost and the quality of the panels and the amount of power that the panels are going to give us all kind of melded together and met our satisfaction. So they have a nice aluminum frame, and they seem to be fairly strong and sturdy. I'll just pull this one out of the way and show you the second one. Both of them are identical. Here's the back side of it. They use the MC4 cables that are marked positive and negative. And see here, positive, negative, and there's another one. I think there's a ground on there too. But yeah, so then my last video, I showed you our cables and adapters and everything came in, and so I'm happy to see that we did get the right cables that will match these and plug right on in. We're still waiting for the rest of our cables and plugs and stuff to come in, but so we've got half of them anyway. And this is the box, wiring box and stuff. And it's got all our data right here. Most of these numbers on here and the lettering and stuff, I don't know what it all stands for, but basically tells you 50 watts, 17.2 volts, and then gives you a bunch of other serial numbers and stuff like that. So they are monocrystalline solar panels by HQRP, and they are from China, but they had a lot of excellent reviews. I couldn't find any negative reviews on them. I did find just over 100 reviews on these panels, and out of those 100 reviews, most of them were between 3 to 5 star ratings. And the only negative comments I found on them were about shipping. All the positive comments on them were about the quality of the power that they were getting off of them. Most of the people in the comments talked about how they got more power than what they expected to get out of than what the panels said they would give. So that was good news. So here, are the charge controllers. Each panel came with a charge controller as part of the purchase. And I won't be using these charge controllers. I'll probably just store them as a backup emergency charge controller or use them for individual things. I will have a separate solar panel. If we have a well on a property, we'll have a 12-volt pump on it and hooked up to its own battery and its own solar panel. So I'll probably use this charge controller for that and stuff like that. But for our main power source, we have our own charge controller, which I showed you in another video. So these two charge controllers that we got here today, with one with each of these panels, show you the other one here. We'll just keep these in storage until we have a come up with a use for them. But by no means will we get rid of them, so it'll be nice to have extras. Here, it has the solar panel wires come into here, battery wires come out there, and then it has a dump load wire comes out here for light bulbs, for lighting or whatever you're using for a dump load. And then has a thermometer sign here, so I guess that in some way, shape, or form tells you the temperature. And then it has a PV here, which has a charging overvoltage light, and it has a battery light. And according to the different color, red, green, or orange, or whatever, will tell you how full the battery is. Then it has a load timer, load one timer, load two timer, and battery type lights. And it has a work mode, and with a LED number system there. And then it has a on-off switch, so you can turn this on and off. And so it's pretty much straightforward. Not too big of a deal, not too complicated, but just a real basic charge controller. So there you have those. And then these keychains here, they're just kind of like these little rubbery things. We didn't pay for these. These are just something they toss in with each purchase. Every purchase that you get from them with a solar panel, they toss in one of these. And I guess they're supposed to like change colors and let you know how much UVA, UVB exposure you're getting. And then it tells you what somehow it's supposed to tell you what level of SPF you're supposed to be wearing at the time. So I don't see any instructions for these. They don't smell like anything but rubber. I'm wondering when you put it out in sunlight if a number pops up in the center or something like that. Who knows? But anyways, I'm guessing, you know what, the center probably changes colors to match one of these colors, and then it tells you what your exposure is, and then you match up the color to your UV, to your SPF bottle or something like that, I bet. So, anyways, my wife kind of wanted these to play around with, so she got lucky and got a set of those. So, alrighty, there's my solar panels. We're going to test these two out when we get down to Pennsylvania. And if these work out great, then we will purchase two more. And my goal is, if these panels turn out to be as good as the reviews and everything said they were, then my goal is to ultimately have probably 6 or 8 of these. And I can't remember exactly how much I paid for them. So when my wife gets home and she pulls out the bills and reminds me how much we paid, I will let you know. It's somewhere between $200 and $300, so including shipping and everything. So, alrighty, thanks for watching FixedByDoc, and have a great day.